Hi friends, welcome to this wonderful program called Train Your Brain, how to enhance our memory. Most of us go to school, we understand the lesson from our teachers, but we forget how we can remember, how we understand how does the brain function. So I'm going to take you through a beautiful journey, but before that, let me tell you who I am. My name is Squadron Leader Jayasimha. I'm the President World Memory Sports Council for India, only Indian with maximum Guinness World Records in the whole world. I'm a motivational speaker, trainer, and a counselor, and I'm an author as well. I've written many books and two famous books. One is called Train Your Brain, another is The Ultimate Guide to Improve Your Memory, best-selling books in India and abroad. And I had been training students, adults, professionals in India and abroad as well. I also conduct memory championships so that we can showcase our brain power to the whole world. It gives me immense pleasure talking to all the students, teachers, faculty members, staff, deans and directors of our Sri Chaitanya group of institutions. I'm very thankful to our chairman, Sri B.S. Rao sir. Because when I started my journey as a memory trainer, I still remember, I started conducting memory championships first time with Sri Chaitanya group of institutions. I have been to every Sri Chaitanya school in Andhra Pradesh, that time Andhra and Telangana, right? So we are going to unearth few memory secrets. Because memory is a long journey, we are going to be together trying to learn whatever teachers are teaching. You understand how to remember, I will take you through. But two, three things that you need to understand before I start about memory. Many people say I have got good memory. Some people say I have got bad memory. Let me tell you, there's nothing called good or bad memory. We have two kinds of memory. One is trained memory. Second is untrained memory. That means naturally we have some memory. But if you go through training, we can improve our memory. So memory is like what? Skill. Anything that you learn by doing is called skill. That like the way you learn to ride a bicycle, the way you learn to drive a bike, the way you learn to drive a car, the way you learn to operate one laptop. Similarly, brain is a gadget. If you know how does it function, how does it remember, if you learn, if you master, whether you want to become an IIT engineer, you want to become a doctor, you want to become IAS officer, you want to have super memory, doesn't really matter. I will take you to the entire gamut of this beautiful journey called memory. And second concept, they say that memory comes by birth. Do you think so? If that was the case, then Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam was born in a small village near Rameshwaram. His mother, father, both of them were illiterate. When he was a kid, he went to a small school near a masjid. But when he grew up, he went on to become India's number one scientist, role model, Indian president, Bharat Ratna. So what did you understand? 20% of our brain health depends on our parents. 80% is developed through training. Understand? 80%. Like Sachin. Naturally talented cricketer, but even then he has to go to MRF Foundation, the coaching center, and he has to keep practicing it. Then he becomes a beautiful batsman. Yes or no? Exactly the same thing. And the last thing you'll ask me is that if we go through Jayasimha's entire memory workshop, is it okay we will stop going to school? No. Because our Sri Chaitanya group of schools, we got the wonderful teachers. I'm not going to replace your teacher. I'm only going to supplement. How? You have a knife. If you sharpen it, you can cut faster. Correct? Some fire is happening. You add some ghee. Right? It will happen faster. Right? Imagine there is a chemical reaction. You add one catalyst, will happen faster. Yes or no? So similarly, we go to school and we go to our college to understand the concepts. But your problem is, I understand, sir. I seem to remember in my classroom, but later I don't remember. How can I remember? How can I reproduce in my examination so that I can get good grades? Because Sri Chaitanya is always number one in the whole country. Yes or no? So I'm going to help you with those techniques. And you can use your teacher and use me. Both of them, if you club, you'll become a lethal weapon. That's how the whole program is going to go. So this memory is a big ocean. I will teach you one or two techniques. But first doubt you will ask me is, Jayasimha, you said you have so many Guinness World Records. Yes, so many Guinness Records, that too in memory. What did you do? I will show you one demonstration. Otherwise, you will say, no, you think really has got memory? You have a question, right? So, I have got my colleague, Mr. Murthy. He will tell me some numbers, random numbers. See some mobile, because you think that numbers are being already told before. No, I've got this empty board. He will put that, you know, mobile, and that random numbers will come. He will tell the random numbers. I will write all the random numbers on the board. One look at the numbers. How will I be able to reproduce these numbers is what I'm going to show you. Then I will teach you the basic memory techniques today. Thereafter, I will teach you how we can remember the numbers, constants, equations, formulas, then science subjects, then historical years, everything I will teach you. But we will start our journey through a small memory demonstration. Are you excited? Sit back, relax, and enjoy this beautiful, you know, memory demonstration. Murthy, could you kindly come up and show me some numbers? And Murthy is my colleague, and he's also a memory trainer. He is working with me, and he has done a lot of programs in many, many schools, and he will be actually teaching you a little later as well. So he has got one mobile, and he is going to switch on that stopwatch. The last two digits which will come randomly, he is going to press them, and then he will tell those two digit numbers, whichever is coming, and I will write those numbers on the board for you. Okay, Murthy, you tell me those two digit numbers.
Okay,
sir. Yeah.
37. 27.
forty-six, forty-six, sixty-five, sixty-five, ninety, ninety, sixty-nine, sixty-nine, sixteen, sixteen, eighty-five, eighty-five, forty-six, forty-six, sixteen, sixteen, sixty-five, sixty-five, zero-seven, zero-seven, eleven, eleven, sixty, sixty, zero-six, zero-six, thirty-four, thirty-four, seventy-four, seventy-four, fifteen, fifteen, fifty-two, fifty-two, eighty-nine, eighty-nine, twenty-five, twenty-five, fifty-six, fifty-six, ninety-six, ninety-six, thirty-four, thirty-four, seventy-three, seventy-three, thirteen, thirteen, fifty-two, fifty-two, ninety-one, ninety-one, twenty-six, twenty-six, sixty-three, sixty-three, zero-one, zero-one, thirty-five, thirty-five, seventy-two, seventy-two, eleven, eleven, forty-five, forty-five, eighty-five, eighty-five, tw I'm going to look at these numbers. Total, we got how many numbers? I think 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12, 14, 16, 18, 20 into 5 rows. Total 100 numbers are there. I'm going to look at them. Once I look at them and memorize these numbers, and I will request my colleague Murthy to put one blindfold to me, and I will try and tell all the numbers without seeing. Right? So just give me just few seconds. Just let me just memorize. Fine. These are all randomly generated numbers. All of them are in my brain, and I will ask my colleague to put a blindfold to me, and thereafter, and I will show you how I can remember the numbers the way you wanted to remember. Just give me 1 second. So if you are able to see all the numbers, can I start telling all the numbers, Murthy? Right?
Okay.
Okay, fine. I'm going to tell all the numbers. You just see, am I saying the numbers properly or not? Ready?
Okay.
Okay. 37.
Okay.
27.
Okay.
98.
Okay.
And then 11.
Okay.
And then 23.
Okay.
86.
Okay.
65.
Okay.
19.
Okay.
69.
Okay.
16.
Okay.
And then the next number is 85.
Okay.
46.
Okay.
And then 16.
Okay.
And then 65,
okay.
07,
okay.
11,
okay.
60,
okay.
06,
okay.
34,
okay.
74,
okay.
15,
okay.
And then 52,
okay.
89,
okay.
25,
okay.
And then the next number 56,
okay.
Then 96,
okay.
After that 34,
okay.
And then the next number 73,
okay.
And 13,
okay.
52,
okay.
And then the next number 91,
okay.
26,
okay.
63,
okay.
01,
okay.
35,
okay.
72,
okay.
Right after that 11,
okay.
45,
okay.
And then 85,
okay.
24,
okay.
And then the next number that's coming up is 56,
okay.
After that 92,
okay.
11,
okay.
44,
okay.
80,
okay.
12,
okay.
And then after that 48,
okay.
75,
okay.
And then 22,
okay.
Last number is 54. Is that okay. Correct?
Very
right.
Correct,
so thank you so much. Now one more thing that I will do is, can I do all the numbers from backward? You check the board. Can I do one number from back to front?
Okay.
Just let us check the numbers, okay?
Okay.
Can I do all the numbers from backward? One number.
Okay.
Check the numbers.
Okay.
4, 5, and then 2, 2, 5, 7, right? After that 8, 4, and then 2, 1, 0, 8, 4, 4, 1, 1, and then the next number is 2, 9, 6, 5, 4, 2, and after that 5, 8, 5, 4, 1, 1, 2, 7, and 5, 3, and then 1, 0, 3, 6. After that, the next number is 6, 2, and then 1, 9, 2, 5, 3, 1, and then the next number is 3, 7. After that, 4, 3, then the next number is 6, 9. After that, the next number is 6, 5. After that, 5, 2, 9, 8, 2, 5, 5, 1, 4, 7, 4, 3, 6, 0, 0, 6, 1, 1, 7, 0, and after that 5, 6, and then 6, 1, 6, 4, and then 5, 8. The next number that's coming up is, after that, the next number is 6, 1, and then 9, 6, and then 9, 1, after that 5, 6, 6, 8, 3, 2, 1, 1, 8, 9, and then the next number is 7, 2, 7, 3. All the numbers coming, correct?
Correct, sir.
Okay.
Correct, sir.
Now we'll do one more thing now. You take this pencil, okay? You draw them in some rows, okay? Some rows, okay?
Third row.
Forward or backward?
Backward.
Okay, third row backward. One number, two numbers.
Two numbers.
Third row backward, two numbers. Let's check this. 52, 13. And then 73,
okay.
After that 34,
okay.
After that the next number is 96,
okay.
After that the next number is 56,
yeah.
After that the next number is 25,
yeah.
After that 89,
okay.
After the 52, the next number is 15. Is it coming correct?
Correct.
Okay, sir. Now draw them in some columns, okay? Can we divide them into 10 columns? Can you draw them into columns? So you will be able to see 5 rows there. And then you'll see 10 columns that my colleague is going to draw. And ask me any one column number. You just put one column, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 column numbers. Ask me one column number. Any one column number.
Eighth column.
Top to bottom or bottom top?
Bottom to top.
Bottom to top, eighth column. Let's check this. 75. After that 45, after that 73, after that 06, after that 19. Is it coming correct?
Correct.
Right. Now choose one more column.
Seventh column.
Top to bottom, bottom to top.
top to bottom
seventh column. Check this top to bottom seventh column. Check this seventh column top to bottom. Now this is 65. After that 60, and the next number is 34.
Okay.
After that the next number is 11.
Okay.
After that the next number is 48. Coming correct?
Correct.
Okay.
Sir.
Now can you put each box one number?
Okay, sir.
Put each box one number. So what we are doing right now, my friends, is we are going to divide all these 100 numbers into two numbers one box. We are going to divide them into 50 boxes. So my question is, if my colleague Murthy asks me a box number without seeing the board, will I be able to tell the number inside the box? That's a question. Any box number, 1 to 50, any box number. Have I got all the numbers in my brain? That's the question. Done? Ask me any one box number. Any one
36,
box number. 36. Box number 36 is 72. Is that right answer?
Right, sir.
Next one.
25.
56.
Okay.
14. Box number 14 is 65.
Okay. 33.
63.
Okay. 43.
43. 11.
48.
48. 48 box number is 75. Is that right?
Right, sir.
So we'll do one more thing now.
Okay.
You asked me box number, I told inside number.
Okay.
We'll do the reverse game. If you ask me the number inside the box, right?
Okay.
Will I be able to tell the box number of that number? We'll do the reverse checking, okay?
Okay.
Ask me the number inside the box which you have told me. Ask me one number is the box.
Okay, sir. 01.
01. That is box number 34. Next one.
Okay. 56.
56 is in two boxes. One is box number 25 and same number is box number 41 also. Next one.
Yes, sir. 4.
I'm asking the number inside the box.
11.
11. 11 is in actually four places, right? Oh, box number 4 is there, and then same number is there in box number 16, and again same number is there box number 37, right? Again the same number is there, again the box number 43. Four boxes is there, same number 11.
Yes.
Is that right answer?
Yes, sir.
Ask me one more number.
19
is box number 8.
Okay.
85 is in two places, box number 11, and same number is box number 39, also same number is there.
Yes,
right
sir.
Answer?
Yes, sir.
Would you like to check any more?
54,
that is the last box, box number 50. Is that right?
Yes, sir.
Oh, good,
right,
thank
sir.
You so much. Right?
Thank you, sir.
So you can remove the blindfold. Right? Friends, can we give one big applause? Okay. So you have seen me how I'm memorizing numbers, and would you also like to do? And many parents say, what, Jayasimha, we are so excited about this, but what is so great about this? You give all these numbers to us today, but tomorrow, even our children will be able to do. How? Through by-hearting. Guys, by-hearting, everyone can do, but I didn't by-heart. I used one simple memory method. The doctors say, our brain at once, it can remember seven numbers. We call it as one chunk. Like we measure sugar in kgs, petrol in liters. You want to measure the distance in miles or kilometers. You want to measure the cloth in meters. Exactly, the unit for measuring memory is called chunk. One chunk means seven numbers or seven items put together. Our brain, without training, it can remember seven numbers at once. That's why sometime back in Bangalore, in Chennai, in Hyderabad, the landline telephone was only seven numbers. Right now, the landline number has become eight digits. When we write this eight-digit number, what we do? We divide this number into two, split it. Four, space four. Why? So that we remember. Our mobile, 10 digits. How do we write? Five numbers, space five numbers. Like you have your bank debit card, credit card. How many numbers are there? Check. 16. How are they printed? Four, space four, space four, space four. Why? Have you ever thought? Without space, you can't remember. That's why. Why I'm saying all this? See, you want to test anyone's memory in the whole world. Only exam is to give numbers. Why? See, some of you are from Karnataka, you know Kannada. Some of you from Andhra Pradesh, Telangana, you know Telugu. Some of you from Tamil Nadu, you know Tamil. Some of you are from North India, you know Hindi. That means you know your language. If I say something in Telugu, you remember. Malayalam, you don't know. If I say something in Malayalam, will you be able to remember? No. That means place to place, state to state, country to country, the language will change. That's why we cannot test all people in the same language, number one. Number two, one guy is an engineer, other girl is a doctor. If you catch hold of a doctor and ask her to remember engineering subject, will she be able to do? No. Liar. Catch hold of a liar. Ask liar to remember medicine, will be able to do? No. That means subject also will change. But numbers, they won't change. Holland, Poland, Netherlands, England, New Zealand, or India, Pakistan, Bangladesh, Myanmar, Nepal, Bhutan, or Sri Lanka, they won't change. That's why universally they give numbers to see who can remember. And let me tell you, in the year 1994, there was a man by name Jonathan Hong Kong. This guy was from Russia. What did he do? In the first World Memory Championship that happened in America, like this 120 numbers were given to him. He could recall 91 numbers, for which his name entered into Guinness Book of World Records. But people asked, Jonathan, how did you remember? Can you tell us the secret? Unfortunately, he never shared the secret with anyone. 3 years later, in 1997, in a road accident, he, his wife and two children died. With him, the memory secret also got vanished. Thereafter, so many engineers, doctors, people like us, they try to do research, because if someone has done, there must be some technique. What could have been that? After that, now one guy, some time back, what did he do? He remembered 200 numbers, like 91, double. 91 into 2, how much? 182, add 18. 200 memorizing, he broke that person's record. Any idea who is that person? The guy who is standing right in front of you, that is Squadron leader Jayasimha. That was my first Guinness World Records. And from there, today, I am the president for the World Memory Championship. So number one in memory, in the whole of India. And any and every memory trainer or anybody who says I will teach about brain, all of them have got trained by me. I do training and maximum Guinness World Records in the whole world. And you ask Jayasimha, sir, by birth only you had this memory? No. I come from a small place near Hyderabad in the district of Nalgonda, and that's where I was born. Until 17 years, I didn't even go to school. Till 12 years, I didn't even go to school. And at the age of 17, I got into the Air Force as an airman. From there, I went on to become a pilot officer, then squadron leader. So, I left my job as a squadron leader, means major in the army. I left a job. I am actually a Fauji, a soldier. I left my job. I wanted to become a motivation speaker, trainer. I want to teach memory to all the children and also adults, so that children will be able to read without stress. Because our Sri Chaitanya is meant to become number one. That too not by hard work, by smart work. And if you and I, we associate, just imagine during this lockdown period, how Sri Chaitanya, you know, institutions have brought all those trainers, people like us, to your doorstep, sitting at home, you and your children are able to learn all these methods. So I will be with you. So you go to school, you learn from our wonderful teachers in Sri Chaitanya schools, and I will teach you how to remember. If your teachers and I, if we can club, and you can achieve your dream of becoming an IITian, or you can achieve the dream of becoming a doctor, you can become a chartered accountant, you can be an IAS officer, that too with less study. That's what the whole method. Then you say, Jayasimha, you are able to do all this fine, but can you teach your own memory method? That's what I'm going to do right now. So one memory method I will teach you. Now before I teach you, these numbers I will teach you in the next time, okay? Because you need to go through step by step. Why I'm saying you are very keen, excited. You teachers, listen, I want to become a motor, okay, a car race winner. I just go to driving school today. By end of today, will I be able to take part in the car race? No, right? I need to learn brake, clutch, accelerator, and then I need to learn to get one learner's license, permanent license, then I should become a perfect driver. Little practice, then I can go on to become best motor car race winner. Yes or no? So similarly, memory will take some time, and I'm here, I will be there, I will teach you the basic memory methods and also the textbook, whatever your teachers are teaching. You learn one lesson, I'll put the entire lesson in the brain. So your teacher and I, we are going to help you, and that's how Sri Chaitanya, you will be going to be a most potent force in making you a winner. So I will teach you not these numbers, I will teach you little later. but how to memorize words? Can we try and do this? See, I will try and tell you. All of you, I know that you are holding one paper and pen. Keep that paper and pen down. Don't use. I will test your memory. Why? Just now my colleague Murthy tested my memory. Yes or no? If I would have not done this demonstration, even you would have said, oh, what is so great? Does he really got Guinness World Records? You will never believe me, because seeing is believing. So if I know how good is your memory, then I will be able to know whether your memory is improved or not. That's how our dean, our principal, sir, our teachers and your parents, you also will know, yes, by using Jayasimha's memory techniques, it's going to help us. So what we do, you keep the paper and pen down. I will tell you some simple words. See if you can remember them by using your normal memory. If you have good memory, so I will try and make it the best memory. How? Through training. Okay, just listen to me. Ready? Right. I'm going to start now. Okay. First word you remember? Aruna. One girl's name, Aruna. Next one, Charminar. Charminar, where is it? In Hyderabad. Thereafter, T. Lalu Prasad Yadav. I've heard his name. Lalu Prasad Yadav is a very famous politician from the state of Bihar. Like, he was a former Bihar chief minister. He was a former Indian railway minister. Lalu Prasad Yadav. How I remember this name? Lalu. I'm not able to imagine it. Alu, you know, alu means potato. Prasad means you went to a temple. You're asking for some prasadam, prasad. So that priest will give you alu as a prasadam. That fellow name is Yadav. Alu Prasadam Yadav. Alu Prasad Yadav. Lalu Prasad Yadav. He's a very famous politician. So to remember Bihar, I'm telling you the name of Lalu Prasad Yadav. Done. The next one is Goa Beach. Very famous Goa. Right, after Goa Beach, the next one you should remember is Mahatma Gandhi. Remember Mahatma Gandhi. After that, Hari Anna. Anna means what in South India? Brother. Hari Anna. Got Hari Anna? After Hari Anna, the next one is Hima. H-I-M-A. Hima. Remember Hima. After Hima, the next one is music. Music means Sangeet. Remembering, all of you are saying, Jayasimha sir, how many more? My wish, I will tell, you all want to become, you know, state topper, 10 by 10 GPA, better you remember, right? So, music, after music, the next one, remember Bhopal. Bhopal, which state capital? Madhya Pradesh, Bhopal. After that, next one, coconut, remember coconut. After coconut, the next one is Sachin Tendulkar, the Indian batsman. Okay, master batsman, Sachin Tendulkar. After Sachin Tendulkar, the next one is money. Money means what? Paisa, money. After money, the next one is Meg. Meg means what? Cloud. In Telugu, Megam. Tamil, Megam. Kannada, Megam. Means cloud. Or if you don't know Meg, you imagine one girl by name Meghna. Or Meg. Meg means cloud. Thick cloud, we call Meg. Thereafter, Maize Ram. Maize means what? Corn. No, corn means sweet corn. Maize. Ram is Lord Rama. So holding maize, Rama appeared. Holding maize, Rama appeared. So only one single word. Maize, Ram. Maize, Ram. After that, the next one is Nagin. Nagin means big snake. Nagin. The next one is Harbhajan Singh. Who is Harbhajan Singh? Indian spinner. Sardarji, Indian spinner. Harbhajan Singh. The last word I'm going to tell you. Sikh. S-I-C-K. Sikh means Bimar. So many words I have told you. Right now, take that notebook and pen. How many words you think you remember? I want you to check. No need to remember them in the same order. First one, last okay. Last one, middle okay. Anyway is okay. Just see how many words you think remember. I'll give you just 1 minute time. Just check how many words you think remember. And I want to know the number. How many words you think remember? Parents, don't help your children. And children, don't help your parents. And don't discuss. If you know, you write. Don't know? Jayasimha is there to help you. Okay, 30 seconds to 1 minute. Just write them down. How many words you got? 5, 7, 8, 9. You know, reason is what? You are using the Bahati method. I told you Aruna, you said Aruna, Aruna. I told Charminar, Aruna, Charminar, Aruna, Charminar. I told T, Aruna, Charminar, T, Aruna, Charminar, T. So by the time I told Lalu Prasad Yadav, Aruna jump. I told Goa Beach, you forgot your name. I told Mahatma Gandhi, whether you are a girl or a boy, total confusion. The moment I told you Haryana, you are thinking, why the hell am I watching this Sri Chaitanya group of schools program, Jayasimha's program, all this question mark, yes sir, no. That means Bahyating is a big problem. Bahyating we should use. Where, when, how, I will teach you a little later. Right now we should use one method called what? Creative visualization method. See, one method, beautiful method called creative visualization method. What is meant by visualization? Visualization means imagination. Our brain and our laptop both work in similar fashion. If we type something into the laptop, what does it do? It converts the data into binary code 0110. Why? The binary code. The laptop knows only binary code language. Similarly, brain, whether you read Telugu or Kannada or Tamil or English or science, doesn't matter. When it goes inside, brain converts the data into pictures. Why? Brain knows only picture language. The way you have one television in the house, there's one television in the brain. If I tell you dinosaur, what did you see? Dinosaur picture, not the spelling. If I told you Taj Mahal, what did you see? Taj Mahal picture, not the spelling. If I told you apple, what has come to you? Apple picture, not the spelling. If I told you Mahesh Babu, what came to you? Mahesh Babu picture, not the spelling. That means you see pictures. That's why many parents, they complain to me saying that, see my baby, she sees one movie, 6 months, she will be able to tell the whole movie story. But she will go to school, one lesson she will read today, in 5 days she forgets. Reason is very simple. In movie, lot of pictures are there, and then in textbook, pictures are not there. Understand? So that means what? If you remember movies, any use is there? No use. But if you remember textbook, use is there, right? So by using this method, what we're going to do? We're going to convert the textbook, means the data, into pictures. It becomes so easy for you. Because you can see one movie, two movies, three movies in a day without getting tired. And even after 3 months, 6 months, you'll be able to tell the whole story, and it's very interesting and exciting for you. Yes or no? Because brain likes pictures. So similarly, textbook, how can we convert them into pictures? Right now, if I ask you to read 3 pages only, sir, washroom, sir, washroom, sir, washroom. Why? So both are coming, sir. That's why your amma says, movie without breakfast is morning you're sitting. And the moment I tell you to open the book, you tell me about washroom. The point is, brain loves movies, brain doesn't love the pictures. Brain doesn't love the textbook. So how do we do? We are going to convert that into picture. Right now, sit comfortably, all of you. Sit comfortably in the chair. Okay, sit comfortably. Both the feet flat on the ground, hands on the thighs. I'm going to give one command, close your eyes. What you should do, you must keep your eyes closed, right? And once you keep your eyes closed, what you should do, I'll be telling you a nice beautiful story, right? So what you should do, when you close your eyes, switch on the mental television, right? And I'll be telling you a story. In the story, some pictures will come. What you should do is, see those pictures in your mental television. That's all you should do, all right? Until and unless I tell you, open your eyes, you will not open your eyes. Sit comfortably, both the feet flat on the ground, hands on your thighs, gently close your eyes, take a deep breath, hold it, slowly exhale. As you exhale, tell yourself, relax, relax, and relax. One more deep breath, hold it, slowly exhale. As you exhale, tell yourself, relax, relax, and relax. Imagine this one girl called Aruna. Alright? Beautiful girl, Aruna. She went to see Charminar. So imagine Aruna going up the Charminar, coming down the Charminar. By going up and down the Charminar, she got tired. She wanted to have a cup of tea. And then she went to one tea shop. There, Lalu Prasad Yadav was selling the tea. Chai, who? Lalu Prasad Yadav. After having tea, both of them went to Goa Beach to play. You look at the nice, beautiful ocean. The waves are blue. Waves are coming towards you. Beautiful, you know, Goa beach. As you are playing there, suddenly you saw Mahatma Gandhi there. Can you see Mahatma Gandhi? No banyan, no shirt, only dhoti. And one watch is there to the dhoti, holding one stick, chappal, and now the spectacles. Mahatma Gandhi, lean and thin Gandhiji standing there. Standing in the Goa beach, Mahatma Gandhi shouting, Haryanna, Haryanna. Imagine Gandhiji has got one Anna, his name is Hari, he's calling his Anna, like Ramesh Anna, Gop Anna, Lakshman, like this, Hari Anna is calling, only one word. Next one, Hima. That time one beautiful girl, Hima, H-I-M-A, she came, she said, Gandhiji, why are you shouting? Stop screaming, play some music so that I can listen. So Gandhiji now stopped shouting and started playing music, Carnatic music. Why Carnatic music? Karnataka is very, very famous for music. And while playing music, he went all the way to Bhopal. Look at the big board, B-H-O-P-L, Bhopal. He went to Bhopal. And as he went to Bhopal, there, okay, people were very happy. They gifted Gandhiji a coconut, Nariyal. Gandhiji, old man, he cannot eat coconut. What did he do? He went and gave it to Sachin Tendulkar. He gave it to Sachin. Sachin was very happy. He said, Gandhiji, so many people in India, you thought about me. Thank you so much. Badle mein na, in return, take some money. He gave one bag full of money. Imagine one bag full of 2000 rupees pink notes. Bag full of money he gave. And just then, in the sky, you can see thick megh. Megh means black clouds, thick megh. And from the maize Ram is coming out, holding one maize, means corn. Lord Rama appeared. Only one word, maize Ram. Holding maize, Rama appeared, maize Ram. In front of him, one big nagin is dancing, big nagin, snake is dancing. It went down and it stung Harbhajan Singh, that Sadaji spinner. And he became sick. Imagine Harbhajan became blue, green, yellow, violet, he's vomiting, okay? And he's become sick and he became totally sick. So much story I've told you. Keeping your eyes closed. I will ask you some questions. Answer to my questions from the beginning. First of all, one girl, what is her name? Aruna. She went to see Charminar. She wanted a cup of tea. And then who was selling the tea? Lalu Prasadav. They went to play in which beach? Goa beach. There, Humusa Mahatma Gandhi. What was he shouting? Haryanna, right? Haryanna. And just then, one girl who came? Hima. She asked him to play what? Music. And then while playing music, Gandhiji went to which place? Bhopal. They gave Gandhiji what? Coconut. Gandhiji gave it to Sachin. Sachin gave some money. What do you see in the sky? Megh. From Megh, Mezram. Front, what is dancing? Nagin. It stung whom? Harbhajan Singh. He became what? Sick. So far, so good. Nice. Little more story. Continue to keep your eyes closed. Listen to little more story. The moment he becomes sick, he was shouting, oh rickshaw, means there was no other mode of transportation. He was calling for rickshaw, rickshaw, rickshaw. And just then, rickshaw fellow came. He made Harbhajan to sit in the rickshaw. He took him through a desert. Desert means what? Rekistan. Whenever I think about desert, you know Rajasthan, because in India, in the state of Rajasthan, that's where you find a lot of deserts, okay? He took him through a desert. Finally, they went to one place called Dehradun. Read the big board, D-E-H-R-A-D-U-N, Dehradun. What is Dehradun? That's capital of Uttarakhand. They went to Dehradun, and as you were walking, there you saw a nice, beautiful Taj Mahal. Look at that white marble, beautiful Taj Mahal. And you're wondering, how come Taj Mahal there? And suddenly on Taj Mahal, you saw superstar, Tamil superstar Rajinikanth dancing there. Look at Rajinikanth, right? So he's wearing green shoe, yellow pant, right? And then red shirt and white goggles. Funny. Rajinikanth is dancing. Next to him, there's one girl. The name of the heroine is Tripura Sundari. Tri means what? Teen. Pura means loka. Sundari means beautiful girl. Tripura Sundari. Can you remember this name? Tripura Sundari was dancing. As they were dancing, both of them slipped. They went and fell in a huge Bay of Bengal. And they were shouting, help, help, help. And our former Indian cricket captain, Mahendra Singh Dhoni, he jumped. He brought both of them to Chitti Ghar. Chitti in Hindi means chota sa, small. Ghar means house. In Hindi, ghar means house. He brought them to Chitti Ghar. And they're requesting, give us something to eat. And Dhoni is giving them one Tirupatika laddu. Okay? very, very sweet laddu is giving. So story is okay. Let me just ask you the question from the beginning to the end. First of all, one girl. What is her name? Aruna. She went to see Charminar. She wanted a cup of tea. Who was selling the tea? Lalu Prasad Yadav. They went to play in which beach? Goa beach. There whom you saw? Mahatma Gandhi. He was shouting Haryana. One girl who came? Hima. She asked him to play what? Music. While playing music, he went to Bhopal. Then they gave him a coconut. Gandhiji gave it to Sachin. Sachin gave some money. What do you see in the sky? Meg. From Meg, what is coming out? Mezram. Front, what is dancing? Nagin. It went and strung home Harbhajan Singh. He became what? Sikh. He was shouting what? Oh, rickshaw. Rickshaw fellow took him through a desert. They went to Dehradun. There you saw Taj Mahal. On Taj Mahal top, who is dancing? Rajinikanth. Next to him, who is there? Right? So, three persons there. Both of them fell in huge bay of Bengal. And who jumped to Bay of Bengal? Mandi Singh Dhoni. He brought them to Chittigarh. And then he is feeding them a laddu. Story is okay? Right. Let me explain the whole story. Now, eyes closed. Okay. One girl, Aruna, she went to see Charminar. Going up and down, she got tired. She wanted a cup of tea. Lalu Prasad was selling the tea. And they went to Goa beach. And there, Mahatma Gandhi, you saw. And he was shouting, Haryana, Haryana. One girl, Hima, she asked him to play music. While playing music, he went to Bhopal. There, they gave him a coconut. Gandhiji gave it to Sachin Tendulkar. Sachin gave some money. And then you saw Meg. From Meg, Mezram coming out. Nagan is dancing. It went and strung Harbhajan Singh. He became Sikh. He was shooting Oriksha. And Riksha fellow took him through a desert. They went to Dehradun. And there you saw Taj Mahal. On the top, Rajinikanth. Next to him, Tripura Sundari. Both of them fell huge bay of Bengal. Mande Singh Dhoni jumped. He brought them to Chittigarh. And then he's feeding them a laddu. The story is okay. Right now, I'll tell you some words. Check whether the words are there in the brain. Keeping eyes closed. Aruna, Charminar, T. Lalu Prasad Yadav, Goa Beach, Mahatma Gandhi, Haryana, Hima, Music, Bhopal, Coconut, Sachin Tendulkar, Money, Meg, Mezram, Nagin, Harbhajan Singh, Sikh, Oriksha, Desert, Dehradun, Taj Mahal, Rajinikanth, Tripura Sundari, Bay of Bengal, Mahendra Singh Dhoni, Chittigarh, Laddu. All the words are there. Can you write all the words now? Can you say? You can see all the words on the screen. That means what? It just took 2 minutes for you to remember all the 28 words. If I ask you, tell the words forward, all the 28 you can tell. You can tell the backward also. Aruna, Charminar, T, Lalu Prasad Yadav, right? Goa Beach, Mahatma Gandhi, Haryana, Hima, Music, Bhopal, Coconut, Sachin Tendulkar, Money, Meg, Mezram, right? And then after that, Nagin, Harbhajan Singh, Sikh, Oriksha, desert, and then after desert, Dehradun, and then Taj Mahal, Rajinikanth, Tripura Sundari, and then Bay of Bengal, Mahendra Singh Dhoni, Chittigarh, Laddu. You're able to tell me, and even you will be able to tell me backward also. How? Go through the story backward. If I ask you Bahubali story, at the end of Bahubali 1, you say, you will tell me Kattappa killed Bahubali. Next 6 months, Amma didn't sleep only. Why Kattappa killed Bahubali? Why Kattappa killed Bahubali? Then only will tell you know Bahubali 2, why Kattappa killed Bahubali. So, if I ask you the story, what you should do? You should tell me Bahubali 2, why Kattappa killed Bahubali? Then you should come to Bahubali 1. Pacha Bottesna Pillagada Nuvu, that song, no, you should come back. Right, so you go through the story backward. If I ask you, first of all, Laddu, where is he giving? Chittigarh, right? And before that, who is that person? Mahendra Singh Dhoni. He jumped into Bay of Bengal. That auntie's name, Tripura Sundari. Hero's name, Rajinikanth. He was on top of Taj Mahal. Taj Mahal is where? Dehradun. Now, before that, desert. Before that, Oriksha. Right, before that, Sikh. Before that, Nagin. And before Nagin, Mizram. Before that, Meg. Before that, money. Who gave money? Sachin. And before that, coconut. Bhopal. Before that, music. Before that, Hima. Before that, Haryana. Before that, Mahatma Gandhi. And before that, Goa Beach. Before that, Lalu Prasad. Before that, tea. Before that, Charma. Before that, Aruna. You can tell me 28 forward, backward. Yes or no? Then you'll ask me, Jayasimha sir, why did you tell all these words? Why are you wasting our time? I didn't waste your time. I told you that by-hearting is very difficult. This is very easy. But behind this, what is the actual story? The thing is, you have remembered 28 words. Means what? You have just now remembered 28 states of India. Why 28 states? Because after Article 370 was removed, we have only 28 states right now. Aruna, what state is that? Arunachal Pradesh. Charna, where is it? Hyderabad state, Telangana. T, where do you grow? Assam. Lalu Prasadav is which state? Bihar. Goa Beach means Goa. Gandhiji was born in Porbandar. Which place? Gujarat. Haryana means Haryana. Haryana, Haryana. Hima means Himachal Pradesh. Music. I told you Carnatic music means Karnataka. Bhopal, which state capital? Madhya Pradesh. Coconut, where do you grow? Kerala. Sachin. Mumbai means what? Maharashtra. Money means Manipur. Meg means Meghalaya. Mizra means what? Mizoram. Nagin, Nagaland. Harbhajan Singh. Sardaj is Punjab. Sikh means Sikkim. Oriksha means Odisha. Desert, Rajasthan. Dehradun, Uttarakhand. Taj Mahal, where is it? Agra. Agra which state? Who says Delhi? Agra is in Uttar Pradesh. In Delhi we have Red Fort. Not Taj Mahal. Taj Mahal is in Agra. Agra is the state of Uttar Pradesh. And Rajinikanth from Tamil Nadu. Tripura Sundar, name is already there. Tripura. Bay of Bengal. Bengal. Bengal means West Bengal. Mahendra Singh Dhoni. Dhoni, Jharkhand Dynamite, Jharkhand. Chittigarh means what? Chhattisgarh. And the last one, Laddu. Tirupati Laddu, which state? Our state of Andhra Pradesh. You got all the 28 states. Yes or no? That means you'll ask me, Jayasimha sir, how do I know Gujarat means, okay, Gandhiji means Gujarat. Are you Indian or Pakistani? You are from India, right? Don't you know the father of, you know, India is Gandhiji, born in Porbandar, you should know, right? Rajinikanth, famous, celebrated, superstar from Tamil Nadu, don't you know? Sir, I don't like Rajinikanth. Don't like then use M.G. Ramachandran. Don't like use Kamalasan. Don't like use Jayalalitha. Don't like use Marina Beach. Don't like Madre Kamakshi Temple. So coconut, don't you know Kerala? If I don't know Ananta Padmanabhasam Temple. That means what? When you go to a school, your teacher will tell you, right? This state, in this state, one big fort is there. One war happened. One famous person is born. One big company is there. This is where we grow this crop. This is what we export. This is what we import. This state is famous for this. Like this, every state is special for one thing, and that your teacher will tell you. So you don't have to take this only. You don't like Charminar for, Telangana. Take KCR. If you don't like, take Buddha statue there in Tank Bund. Take Golconda. I don't know what you take. See, I have used one method. Through this, what will happen is, by hurting, very, you know, difficult, this is easy. You say without this also you remember. You remember, but when you go to exam, instead of 28, you write 25. 3 missing, instead of 10, miss will go 8. Instead of first rank, you get 5th rank. But this one, you can remember all of them. Once you remember now, once quarterly exam, once half yearly exam, once pre-board, that's all of them are there. Why so much? Right now at home, your grandmom is there. Teach this story. Your grandmother will say, from tomorrow, I also will come to Sri Chaitanya school. Oh my God, look at it. It is so easy to remember the words. Like this, we can memorize all of them. Now, the question I will explain to you is, how you can make the story? Baba, that's what it is. The thing is, I am there, right? I have told you one story. After this video gets over, your mother says, you have seen Jason Master's video. Now, I will give you some words. Will you remember? You say, Ma, you give the words. Jason Master's mobile, I'll call up. He will tell one story, I will tell the words. If you say, Amma will take one knife and she will kill you. Yes or no? That means, when you are small baby, you are walking holding your mummy's finger. But when you grew up, you learn to walk independently, leaving your mother's finger. That means what? Even if I am not there, you should become independent to make your own story. How do you make a story? Listen, story making is very easy. One word you have to connect to the other word. Okay, this we call it as what? Visualization method, story method, or linking method. You know, linking, like Amma want to make one garland of flowers. So what does she do? She will take one thread, one jasmine flower, she'll put one knot, one more jasmine, one more knot, one flower, one more knot, and soon the garland will be ready. Yes or no? Exactly same thing. We are connecting one word to the other word. Exactly like this matter. Linking is what, like, you know, that train has got one engine, and behind this one coupling, connected to the A1 coach. Behind A1 coach, one more coupling that is connected to A2 coach. Behind that, there is one S1 coach, then S2 coach, then this ladies compartment, the general compartment. When the engine starts going chuk 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 chuk, all the bogies will go. So the moment you get one word, second word automatically will come. Understand? Second word automatically will come. And are you getting this? So if I told you Aruna missed what? Next, she went to see what? Charminar will come. And she wanted to drink what? Tea. Who was selling the tea? Lal. One other two other word automatically will come. See, just let me just tell you one more thing. Okay. And then you will understand what it is. See, if I give you some words, okay. I'm giving you some words called troops. I have told you. So what you should do? Imagine army troops. Okay. Army troops. Just imagine one picture called army troops. Army people marching. Next one, I'll give you one word called straw. Means what? Straw means grass. Army troops, they came and sat on a straw. Okay. The next one is what? Mess. Mess is the place where you have your food. Mess. In the school mess, canteen. So, army troops, what I'm trying to do? I'm connecting this with this. Okay. They sat on a straw and then they landed in the mess. The next one you should remember is thermos. What is thermos? Thermos flask. Right now, because of the corona lockdown, dad is at home and morning. Early morning, you want bed tea, 9 o'clock along with breakfast tea, 10:30 one more tea, 12 o'clock one more tea, and evening 4 o'clock. Amma is becoming really sick, serving all of your tea. What will Amma do? She will make so much tea at once, she will put in the thermos flask and she will tell your dad, whenever you are wanting to have tea, you please take one cup and drink. Yes or no? So thermos flask is some flask where you keep the tea. And then the next one is what you should do is what? Excess. You should remember excess is a verb. Means what? So dad is wanting to drink excess tea. Okay. So army troops, they came and sat on a straw. They landed the mess. They found one thermos flask. Since morning they have not eaten anything. They're asking one cup tea, one more cup tea, one more cup tea, one more excess tea they are demanding. So one word to the other word, you have to make a small link and make one nice beautiful story in the brain. So you have to make a story. So you got all the words now. Army troops, they sat on a straw, they went to mess, they found one thermos flask and asking excess tea. 5 words are there. Now tell me, what do you remember? Tell me what do you remember? You just now remembered 5 layers of atmosphere, man. 5 layers. Troops means what? Troposphere. And straw means stratosphere. Mess means mesosphere. Thermos means thermosphere. Excess means exosphere. That means in your school, Miss will explain up to what height is troposphere, what are the characteristics of troposphere, stratosphere, where to stratosphere, and where the aeroplanes fly in the stratosphere. She will tell you this. But your friends, they have to go through difficulty. But if you know this method, it becomes so easy. Understand this. And how can you use this method to your studies? Because the most important thing is, how can you use this method? By memorizing the words. Let me just tell you that this method will go very handy for your English or Telugu, Sanskrit, Hindi or Kannada or Tamil or Malayalam or Gujarati or Hindi book. How? See, any book if you open, you find some 10-12 chapters, correct? In every chapter, you have 45 paragraphs, right? My question is, why do authors write in paragraphs? Why do they write in paragraph? Because each paragraph, it'll have one key idea. Yes or no? Otherwise, they can start from here, they can stop here, right? Why do they break data into paragraph? Because each para has got one key idea, one central theme, one main theme around which the whole para keeps revolving. Understand? So, once the paragraph is over, you can easily assume that one idea explanation is over. One idea explanation is over means paragraph is also over. Very easily you can assume. Sometimes that means what? If there are 40 paragraphs, there must be 40 key points. Simple. But sometimes it might so happen that one para may have 2 or 3 key ideas also. Very simple. In that case, the author might give 2-3 key points also. Or sometime very important point, if he thinks the student has to understand, he will explain in one way, re-explain some other way. He'll give one example, one case study, one illustration. Means one point may also be explained in 2-3 paragraphs. That means if I got 40 paragraphs, between 35 to 45 key points. A smart student, Sri Chaitanya student, will not buy her the whole textbook. Understand this. If you open up any book right now, what you should do after my program, you type your textbook or any book, newspaper, magazine, storybook, novel. You type into your MS Word and 85% only will be the grammar. He, she, it, were, but, because, and, although, then, what, when, why, grammar. And 15 to 20% only will be the matter. Grammar, we don't focus. Matter, we focus. Like mummy churning the curd. You get cream, little. Buttermilk, so much. We, buttermilk is not so valuable. So that grammar, comma, full stop should come from your understanding. Only the main points you should remember. So the moment Miss is teaching, she taught you one paragraph, she explained you, she will tell, in this paragraph, this point is very important. You must understand this concept. This idea you have to follow. You underline them, right? And then Aruna, Charna, T, like troops, no, underline all of them. And then make one story. And next time when you go to school, and then write one point, underline. Explain that in one or two sentences. Second point, underline, explain that in one or two sentences. Wherever it is, you can very easily explain. That's how you can remember long answer essay questions. And this, I will do the whole training. It is very easy to say. I'm explaining you for you to an idea, because this modules we are doing right now, this training programs to you, so that you get interested, you get convinced that yes, memory is very essential for us to learn, so that we will continue to use it all our life. That's why I'm doing this program. But I will take your book one after other. I will teach you the entire textbook just like that. So you attend 1 month class, and one day you give it to me, that entire 1 month syllabus, I'll put that in your brain. And then what? So you got 10 months, you're going to school, 10 days you give it to me, everything is in the brain, 10 by 10. And rest of the time, sarigama padanisa karo karo jalsa. Okay, happily you can dance, nothing to do. Why your amma is telling you to study? Why your appa is telling you to study? Why teachers are telling you to study? Because you don't know the answer. If you know the answer, why they'll say? If they say, tell the answer, you say, mame, ask. All answers are okay. Go, cook. Sarigama padanisa karo karo jara jalsa. Okay. Happily you can enjoy, no? So people say, do hard work. Beta, hard work days are not there anymore. Smart work. All of you go to the same school, same teachers, same textbook, same question paper, same 24 hours. All of you want to get the first rank only in the school. But everybody doesn't get, yes or no? What is the difference between the guy who gets the first rank, who gets the last rank? First rank fellow has got what? 4 hands and 6 legs? Huh? No, sir, he has got 3 mothers. No, he also has got only one mother. He also got 2 hands and 2 legs. Everything is same. But what they do, they physically everything is same. But what they do is, now normal people, they do hard work. And the toppers, they do smart work. Sri Chaitanya is about smart, making you smart. Winner for life. That's very important. Winner. So not only that you'll be topper in school, but the way you remember, it's just like that you can remember. And what? We are partnering with Sri Chaitanya and we are going to be together. Right? And you got the best teachers, best management and best chairman, or Dr. B.S. Rao sir. And we are there. Together we can make you a winner just like that. And you will happily study, not through pain. Happily you will be able to study. And that's how you are able to use this method. Right? Beta, driving. Brake, clutch, accelerator. First gear, reverse gear, all of them are same for everybody. One person from Hyderabad, he want to go to Tirupati. Rasta, different. One guy want to go to Anantapur. Now, different. One guy want to go to Chennai. Different. Right? Rasta, different. But the car driving is same. Yes or no? So, brain, the way it functions is same. You have to learn the memory training first. Thereafter, I will take the textbook and I'll put the whole textbook in the brain, and that's it. Within 3-4 months, all the teachers, whatever teaching, you are there. So don't get worried, don't get in depression, don't get concerned that we are almost 1 month sitting at home, nothing is happening, everything is happening. Sri Chaitanya is with you and your children are taken care, not only physically, psychologically, but academically, and best of the trainers are going to come. And I'm so privileged to be with all of you. And my journey as a trainer started with Sri Chaitanya. as a World Memory Council President. I did the first memory championship and have gone to every school in Andhra and Telangana. And I'm sure I would love to come and train you, and you can also get trained online as well. So you can visit my website if you want to, jayasimha.in, and I will be here to help you. But in any case, and I'm sure we have to thank our chairman, sir, and all the deans and the principals and the teaching staff and academic and non-academic staff, everyone who are 24 hours concerned, right? They are so much interested in training all of you. So hope you enjoyed this session. I know you will still have a lot of questions. You want to learn more from me, but we are there with you. This is the trailer of RRR. Trailer. So the actual thing is going to come. But just to show you that yes, Sri Chaitanya is committed for your children's success 24/7. For that, Jayasimha is with all of you, and I really loved being with all of you, and hope you have, you must have enjoyed this beautiful session. And you have any more questions, you can call me up, and you can mail me, or you can ask your teachers, and they'll give you my contact number, my email ID. Others, we will if you say yes, this program, we like it, we want more of memory, you just send one message to your teachers and your principal, sir. And then I will bring the whole of the memory workshop at your doorstep. So sitting right at home, you and then your sister, your brother, mom, dad, grandparents, all of you can learn together, and all of us can become memory literal people. And then for you, you say anything, anytime, 24/7, Sri Chaitanya is ready. Thank you so much. Love you all. Take care. We shall meet up again. Till then, bye-bye.